स्टोरी श्रीका। वंस इन अ विलेज देयर लिव्ड अ यंग मैन। ही यूज्ड टू बी ऑलवेज वेरी लेजी। हिज पेरेंट्स नेम्ड हिम करमवीर, बट इन रियलिटी ही वाज एब्सोल्युटली गुड फॉर नथिंग।
ओ माय डियर सन, गो एंड फाइंड सम वर्क फॉर योरसेल्फ। सी हाउ योर फ्रेंड्स आर डूइंग सम वर्क और द अदर।
मॉम, व्हाई डू आई हैव टू वर्क व्हेन माय फादर एंड माय ग्रैंडफादर हैव ऑलरेडी लेफ्ट सो मच वेल्थ फॉर मी।
बट सन, फॉर हाउ लॉन्ग आर यू गोइंग टू यूज दिस वेल्थ? समडे यू विल हैव टू वर्क एंड अर्न फॉर योरसेल्फ।
दैट डे विल नेवर कम। I will rest at home all my life.
Saying this, Karamveer leaves his house to meet his friend Pashupati at his place. Though Pashupati was Karamveer's friend, but he was very jealous of him.
Hey Karamveer, what's the latest story you have come to share?
My friend? Why are you saying this? When have I ever told you a story?
Hey Karamveer, relax. I was just kidding with you, my friend. You never ever make up stories. In fact, you always say the truth.
That's exactly what I always say. By the way, I want to tell you something which I have never told you.
And what is that?
My friend, I was a king in previous life. That too, a very brave and majestic king. I had a huge treasure. But one of my ministers betrayed me and conspired with a neighboring kingdom and got me killed.
He started thinking that what is his new story?
But Karamveer, how can you remember your past life?
That is the most important thing. I was a gifted child. I started speaking as soon as I was born.
Oh, I see. Okay, I trust you since you're saying so.
All right, friend. I'll go now.
Okay, bye.
Karamveer leaves from there. And Pashupati starts wondering that how Karamveer manages to lie so much. He just keeps watching Karamveer go. Days pass like this. But as they say, there is always an end to everything. Likewise, Karamveer's wealth started diminishing and eventually all his wealth finished. And even Karamveer's mother was very sick.
Son, we have nothing left now. Whatever your father or your grandfather had earned has been lost.
But how did everything finish so fast? We had a lot of wealth and money.
It doesn't matter how much wealth or money you have. But if you don't save it, it is bound to finish very soon, my son.
But I had thought that entire life I will not have to work at all. And I will spend my entire life sitting at home without doing any work.
I tried to make you understand a lot, but you never gave me a heed. If you would have done some work, then we wouldn't have suffered so much. Even I have grown old now and I'm sick too. And I know very well I will not be alive for too long.
Mom, please don't say all this. If you leave me, how am I going to survive?
Days kept passing by. And finally, Karamveer had to get out of his house in search for some work. He suddenly thinks that why not take Pashupati's help? And he decides to go and meet his friend Pashupati.
Hey Karamveer, how come you are at my place?
Friend, today I have come to seek your help.
What kind of help? Let me know. What can I do for you?
All my wealth is over, my friend. Now I'm left with nothing. Can you lend me some money, please? I will return it to you very soon.
Well, I don't have any money to lend you. I'm just a blacksmith. Whatever I make in the entire day is just about enough to feed me and my family.
So, will you not be able to help me?
No. I will not be able to help you in any way. And by the way, you were a king in your past life. So please go to your palace, where your treasure is still hidden.
Listening to this, Karamveer leaves from his house. Pashupati is very happy watching Karamveer's condition. Karamveer did not knew about what to do and how to do. He just keeps walking from one village to the other village. And as he kept walking, finally, he reaches the palace.
I have reached the palace, so I should go straight to the king and ask for some work.
With this thought, he walked straight towards the palace. One of the qualities Karamveer had was he could bluff very well. He could bluff so much that it was really difficult to tolerate. He reaches the palace and goes in front of the king.
My lord, please give me some work.
The king looked at him from head to toe and asked him,
"And what are you good at?"
And he bluffs again.
I can do anything that nobody else can do.
the king looked at his ministers and then asked his chief minister.
Tell me, minister, what do you suggest?
You cannot make out from anyone's face, king, and there is no harm in giving him a chance.
Even the king thought that if he is saying something, then it's possible that he is of some worth. With this thought, the king said,
okay, I appoint you on salary of 1 cent per day.
Thank you, my lord.
Karamveer was very happy as he was getting 1 cent every day without doing any work. He was counted among some of the important men in the palace. He enjoyed this comfort for some days until one day when he found himself in trouble.
Our neighboring enemy kingdom has attacked us. Their king is too powerful and he has a very big army too. Whereas in comparison, our army is way too small. How are we going to fight with them?
All ministers and men in the courtroom were asked for their suggestions. All ministers, after discussing with each other,
my king, why don't we seek suggestion from Karamveer? Even he's an important person. He can do what no one else can do. That is what he had said.
Oh yes, nice idea. Call for Karamveer right away.
The king was relieved from all his tensions. On the king's order, Karamveer was summoned in the court.
Karamveer, large army of our neighboring enemies have attacked us. I want you to save our state.
Listening to this, Karamveer's heart started pounding, as if his life is just about to end. But he did not express his fears in front of the court. And as usual, he started bluffing.
My lord, I can disseminate the entire army alone. You just relax and don't worry. You just see how I will make the enemies run for their life tomorrow morning.
Listening to Karamveer's assurance, the king took a sigh of relief. But Karamveer was terrified from within. Although he had made tall claims in front of the king, he started sweating thinking about enemy's large army. And he thought to himself,
I think the time has come to run away from this palace. It's better for me if I flee away tonight without any delay. And by the time it's morning, I'll be beyond the state's boundaries.
The king called Karamveer as soon as it was morning to strategize how to fight the enemy. But the guard said that he could not find Karamveer anywhere in the palace.
My lord, we have searched each and every corner of this palace, but Karamveer is not to be found.
How is this possible? He has betrayed us. I order you to confiscate all his wealth. And anyone who will bring him in this courtroom will get a handsome prize. It's an order.
Then in desperation, the king had to send his army on the border. On the other hand, Karamveer kept walking and reached the forest. He was very hungry. He thought of eating some of the 3 rotis that he was carrying along with him. So he sat down near a well in the forest and he opened his packet.
There are 3 rotis in here, but I'm not sure how long will I have to travel.
Thinking this, he was unable to decide.
Should I eat 1 or 2 or should I eat all 3 at once?
He kept on repeating this to himself. There lived 3 fairies in the well near which he was sitting. As soon as they heard Karamveer's words, they all got frightened. They thought someone has come to eat them.
Who is this man and why he wants to eat us all? Come on, let us go and talk to him.
Then all 3 of them came out of the well and they said to Karamveer,
hey traveller, what have we done to you? Why do you want to eat us?
Karamveer was clueless at first, but later he understands and he says,
No, I will eat all of you.
Look, traveller, this is not right. Why do you want to eat us?
I don't know what is right or wrong. I just want to eat you.
Look, traveller, if you promise that you will not eat us, we can give you some really amazing things.
And what are those things?
Take this. These are 2 feathers. Once you wear them on your head, you can fly anywhere you want.
This is a magical sheet, wearing which you can see everyone, but no one will be able to see you.
Take this. This is a magical sword. It starts working once you hold it in your hand, and no enemy can face its strength.
Looking at this, Karamveer was astonished and happy. He took all 3 things from the fairies and wore the feathers on the head. Wrapping the sheet and holding the sword, he says,
I want to go between the enemies.
As soon as he said this, he was in the battlefield, where the enemy had already dominated Karamveer's army.
But as soon as Karamveer reached there, everything turned upside down and all the enemy soldiers started running for their lives.
I think there is some ghost who is helping this army.
As soon as the enemy realized this, the entire army started running back to safety. When the king learned that they have won the war and some magical power has helped them in this war, everyone in the courtroom, including the king, was surprised.
How did this miracle happen? And which unseen power has helped me in this battle?
By then, Karamveer reaches the court, swinging the sword in his hand.
All hail the king! We have won this battle!
King welcomed him with open arms.
Come, Karamveer. So you were that unseen power.
Everybody in the court stood up in his respect. And then the king announced that he will get his daughter married to Karamveer.
I have decided to get my daughter married to Karamveer.
Finally, Karamveer had got all he wanted. And he got married to the princess. And he became responsible and he stopped bluffing around. And he finally could justify the true meaning of his name.